get right into it. This is very important. You guys, I'm going to show you side-by-side comparison and explain what's going on, and this is going to help a lot of you. And please bear with the vertical video for a little while. I'll still do some landscape ones, but my channels on the other social platforms have been like blown up, and I don't have the time to take care of everything, to make videos and answer comments. We get thousands of comments across all these platforms, and I'm running short on time, and there's so many other things that we want to do in conjunction with this. So I was taking landscape videos and trying to cut, you know, vertical videos out of it, and it just didn't work right. So I'm filming some on here because a lot of our stuff is going vertical, right? Like our towers, we got a lot more of the target buckets we're going to be setting up, our buckets, our ladder system. We're doing a lot of vertical gardening. The vertical format kind of fits with that, and then I can take that and easily cut it up and put it onto TikTok and Facebook Reels and Instagram and Pinterest and all these other places. So it's helping my workflow a lot. Bear with me. I'll do some more landscape for you people just like that. But this is helping my workflow. And believe it or not, it's helping a lot of people out there, because the more people that learn these things, just like here, when people say thank you, thank you, thank you, I get people all over TikTok saying thank you, and they're all over the world, you know, like they're trying different things, and there's people all on Facebook. And so this helps my workflow, and I really appreciate you guys just being a little patient with the vertical video. I don't like it. You know, I like filming landscape, but it's helping my workflow a lot, which means it's helping a lot more people out there. And that's the main thing, is that we help people, right? So we'll get out into the garden, and I've got some cilantro. This doesn't pertain just to cilantro. That's just what I've grown. And sometimes when I have some extra, I like to just do these little experiments side by side just to show you guys. And these came from the seed packet from True Leaf Market. The cilantro came in there, and I grew one set of microgreens, and I took them and put them in our downspouts like we do. And I took some and put it on our ladder system where we have the Mylar bags. Now, I put the Mylar bags up, and we stapled it to steps. So the top step, you know, there's nowhere to set the bag up on top there. So I wasn't using the top step. So I set one of the things of cilantro up there. Now, the reason why I did that was because we have an overhang, and I don't usually use that top step because it doesn't get a whole lot of sunlight because of the overhang. So even though everything else will get sun, that doesn't. Sometimes I put something up there if I don't want everything to come in all at once, and that'll grow a little slower, then we'll harvest this and then move one down. But generally, you know, we don't use the very top step. So I toss the cilantro up there, and you guys can see now side by side the difference that it makes. Both of these were grown at the same time. They came from the same microgreens. I took them, I put them in the same nutrients and the same type of container. So everything basically is the same except for the location. And the location isn't like one was grown in a neighbor's yard or down the block or in a different city or a different state or something, right? It was like literally like 20 or 30 feet away. So in your yard, when you're looking at it, people have to stress out when you do a traditional garden. And that's why they talk about, you know, north facing, south facing, or whatever, and how many hours of sunlight, and you have to look at all of this stuff and plan, and you might not put your garden where you want it. It might look good like right there, but you might have to have it over there for some reason, right? So you have to go through all of this stuff, and then once you do it, you're committed to it. You can't just, if you made a little mistake or the season changes, you know, the sun's not going in the same path, you can't up and take your garden and move it, right? So these small containers, that's why I love doing the hydroponics, and they're in small containers. If you want to do the 8-10 foot ones and you have someone to help you move it, that's fine. But if you make these small containers, you can do it yourself, and you can put something somewhere and it's growing and it's not doing right, might just be the sun, just move it a little, watch it, see how long it's getting, you know, get lots of morning sun, not too much of the in the heat of the afternoon and that, and whatever's not working, these things are portable. Even when we're getting into this, where we're stacking up the buckets and everything, you can pick it up and you can move it. And actually, the terracotta buckets that we have out there, the first place I set it up and we put the plants in there, during the midday sun, they just really wilted in that. And all I did was pick them up, and we moved them literally 10 feet to the right to where it would get more shade. and we moved it just 10 feet and the plants are doing just fine right now. And all we do is just pick it up and move it. And with a traditional garden, you can't do that. You can't pick up your garden and move it 10 feet somewhere, right? So that's the fantastic thing about these little containers, growing cracky in these off-grid containers. We're going up to the 5 gallon buckets and that. You can do the totes, once you get into like a 20 gallon tote, it's a little more difficult to move, but if you got somebody to help you pick it up, you can do that or drag it, right? Your garden, you can't do that. So this is where you don't have to stress out in the very beginning and think about where my stuff is facing and how many hours they get in that. Just kind of think about it, put it out and watch it for a day, and experiment. And your seasons do the same year after year. So once you figure this out and you just play around and have fun, put it there. If it doesn't work, move it a little bit. If it looks like they're wilting too much or getting too much sun, move it a little more to the shade. If they're not growing as fast in that, maybe give it a little bit more sun. But you have options with this. And that's what I love about the system, and it's just fun. And I love showing you guys side by side. A lot of you, your brain, the first thing you first think when something's not working right is it's got to be the nutrients. What's wrong with the nutrients? I didn't mix it up right. It's stagnant water. There's no aeration. Maybe I should do this. Maybe I should do this. And the fact is that it might just be the sunlight. It might be something as simple as moving it 5 feet in one direction and you're going to get a lot better growth. So don't forget about that. All the other stuff is important. We look at that, but don't overlook that, because there's a lot of you that you could solve probably like half your problems out there. Is just taking your stuff and moving it around a little bit. Just because you put it outside and it's in a sunny spot doesn't mean it's in the optimal spot. And with this system, you can take it and you have options. You can move it around. You can change it. If something happens and you keep your microgreens growing, you can just get rid of those and put some more back in. Just like this cilantro, right? That one's not growing good. I wouldn't have let it go that long. I would have known right from the beginning. I would have took it and moved it. And if I didn't, I've got some that rain just beat it up really bad, and then the sun came out and it just, they're off to a bad start. I know that I can just pull them out and I've got more cilantro to go in right behind of it. That's the beauty of the system, and that's why we grow fast growing greens, is that you can keep doing this. The tomato plants, they mess up, you've lost months of work. So I hope that helps. Like I said, don't forget, the sun's your friend. It can be your enemy in that, but the plants need the sun. That's what they make their food out of. That's what they use for photosynthesis. That's one of the most important factors, and you guys just glaze over that and go right for the water stagnant or something like that. So keep that in mind. I hope that helps. We're going to come back. We'll have other videos like this. We've got a podcast started. Excited about that. So lots going on in home and garden. I'm going to be putting up some videos over there. Keely's got her art studio. I know we've been saying this for a while, but we've got so much that went on. And then Keely had something going on with her health, and we'll share that in the group. But lots of fantastic stuff going on. I love you guys. We'll catch you later. Lift, inspire. Keep on growing. Be the change. Go grow something.